Professor McGlade, I would like to ask you, what do you think has something changed over the last years, especially 2019, or is it just business as usual?
I think all around the world, people have come to the conclusion that not only is climate change really going to happen and make the world a very difficult place to live in with dramatic effects like the fires in Australia, but I think it's made some people feel that they need to actually take that message deep inside themselves and look again at how they're living. And I particularly identify scientists, some of the most outspoken climate scientists are now translating what they're saying to others into their very own lives. And that shift, both in the sort of the deep psyche and what it means for our social values, is the fundamental change. And for the first time, climate change was listed as the greatest threat in virtually every country when people were surveyed.
So this is a hopeful development, would you say?
Well, I think it's a necessary condition if we want to make the transformations that I believe are absolutely fundamental to effectively making sure that we can thrive on the planet. And if we do not address the transformation at a deep level, what we will do is fritter away time. We will think that technology can solve all of our problems and discover in 10 years that we're back in exactly the same situation that we're in today.
You have experience with many different cultures and the different approaches people take to nature, to the environment. What lesson would you like to pass on from those experiences to people in Austria, to a government in Austria? What can we learn from them?
I think the first point is to really respect those who are living in nature and are surviving and doing more than that, because in a way they've never lost that emotional and the natural intelligence that it takes to be able to live and to rely on nature for your very being, your shelter, food, and so on. But I would like to also stress that it's as much about the learning experience as listening. Being able to listen through people's experiences and extract what is necessary. And I would go to the other end of the scale and say that when a country like New Zealand and the leader there takes the decision to essentially turn a budget upside down and say that it will be premised on well-being and not on economic development alone, then you begin to see how the levers of government can genuinely take nature on board, but still have the possibility of prosperity for the population.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.